speed up for Nandini for giving me the opportunity to share with all of you two interesting cases. And these are the quite challenging cases to me. I don't know that whether it will be challenging to you also.
A 37-year-old male from Malaysia came with a complaint of units of between the left eye of 15 years duration in October 2014. He was consulted locally and diagnosed to have acute retinal necrosis in the left eye, given internal fasciectomy for 15 days, followed by the tablet vasectomy 1 gram PDS and tablet prednisone in Keparindo. Laser barrels were also done. Investigated elsewhere, quantum TV gold test was positive. His visual acuity was 66 in the right eye and 66 partial in the left eye, after the photometry, 40 in the right eye, 20 in the left eye. Antecedent quite no vitreous cells. Trace anterior chamber cells and vitreous cells were seen in the left eye. And this is the fundus picture of the right eye, is absolutely normal. But if you look at the left eye, there is a peripheral retinal choroiditis, patches were there, and this is the laser barrel. And there is a central area, there is a geographic choroiditis patches. So what is the diagnosis? Is it definitely not an acute retinal necrosis, but is it an ATACT? Acute retinal necrosis, multiple serpiginous choroiditis. Multifocal serpiginous choroiditis. Yes, it's a multifocal serpiginous choroiditis. And what the investigators will do? I did the multi test, HSCD test, fundus fluorescein angiogram and OCT. The patient had anterior inflammation, and the patient suspected for viral infection. And see, I did the anti-chamber tap for PCR for PAE, HSV, CGSV, and NCV. Fixed clearance for steroid and immunosuppressive agents were obtained. Fundus fluorescein angiogram, early hyperfluorescence, and then in the, you can see the geographic choroiditis patches were seen. And in this is the area of blood margin. OCT, right eye was normal, left eye was a subretinal phase, some material was there, deposits were there. Mark test came positive with ulceration, particular TB gold test was positive. HSC test was suggestive of tuberculosis. Chest physician's opinion sought and started on 4 gram regimen of ATP. On FFK, OS phobia was treated, started intravenous past methylprednisolone therapy after medical treatment. ACTAP sent for PCR for CME, HSV, BJP and NTP. PCR was negative for viruses and NTP, antivirals were stopped, doctor opinion sought, steroid responded, started on Combigan eye drops and the intraocular pressure was elevated. Intraocular pressure came with anti-glaucoma medications, aurora steroid, bonus to the open angle. Lesion starts to be healing. And you can see the lesion starts healing in the left eye. Further decline in the lesion to the corneal edema, then patient required anti-glaucoma medications, part of the diamox and anti-glaucoma medications, decision to take for the corticosteroid. Visual acuity 6610, 6910, quite no vitreous cells, lesion starts healing. Right eye, you can see the lesion started healing. This is the fundus fluorescein angiogram right eye and the left eye. Tablet prednisone 35 mg and 80 photograph was given and was monitoring intraocular pressure locally. Right eye same as before. Left eye showed new lesions at the periphery while on the steroid and anti-VEGF treatment. Now the question is that is it an autoimmune? Is it a viral? Is it a tubercular drug resistance? Is it an inadequate anti-inflammatory drug? This was the dilemma. probably damn itself TV or Indian internet insurance program. This is a funded program, close to 90 grams. Here I saved up to 60 million per day, 80 of confidence, doctor opinion shot, review after 1 month. After 1 month, vision is normal, lesions, new lesions. Now come to the right eye, new lesions noted. You can see the new lesions in the right eye, all in the mid-periphery. Funded close to 90 grams. Left eye lesions are healed. So left eye lesions healed, right eye new lesions developed. New lesions. So is it a drug resistance in reference to HP, inadequate immunosuppression, misdiagnosis, or the use of systemic steroids? Probably inadequate immunosuppression. We used the tablet azathioprine or static, 50 mg TDS added. No new complaints. Clinically healing lesion, both eyes, 75-80% healing, OCT CAE noted. Lesions have started healing after azathioprine. You can see the lesions start healing. Autofluorescence. This lesion OCT in January 2015 is a new lesion skin. There is a cystoid macular edema. A month later, quite no weaknesses, green lesions, review after 1 month. Final review of 3rd month 2015, quite only quite heal lesions, vision making, glaucoma opinion short, continual anti-glaucoma medication, IV monitored doctor, azathioprine 50 mg twice daily, and brain stroke cephalosporin, due for review. With azathioprine, the lesions started resolving. Right eye lesions healed. Left eye lesions seen. Foveal thickness decreased in the left eye. So news from Malaysia came that the vision is stable. Tablet prednisone 50 mg daily. Intraocular pressure uncontrolled with maximum therapy. Developed arthritic keratitis and trabecular eye drops have been stopped and started on topical antiviral drugs. Glaucoma sun study done in the left eye in the 2015. This was the Whitefield angiogram, top one, showing the lesions and me. So in summary, last case of Mantua surgery and choroiditis, positive tubercular based on the necrotic Mantua, quantical TV voltage and chase speaker, put on ATP and oral steroids, developed keratin in glaucoma, developed recurrence in the same eye and new lesions after that, resolved after addition of immunosuppressive agents. So what I want to highlight, the antiviral medication might not be sufficient to the steroids to control the intraocular inflammation. Intraocular inflammation may require addition of the immunosuppression and that requires immunosuppressive medication. I just don't want to discuss not much in except that subcutaneous steroids is mostly bilateral, multiple subcutaneous is mostly unilateral, unifocal geographic lesions mainly in the posterior cone, multiple lesions in the posterior cone and lesions extend from the gastrocnemius choroid to subcutaneous choroiditis. Multiple subcutaneous choroiditis lesions mostly scare the gastrocnemius choroid. Vitritis is absent, vitritis is present. And this is the typical choroiditis of subcutaneous and multiple subcutaneous choroiditis. Choroiditis and multiple subcutaneous tend to begin as multiple vesicles between the posterior cone and mid-periphery, which qualifies over time. Presumed tubercular subcutaneous and choroiditis where Dr. Vishal Gupta has reported and yet the acquired tubercular subcutaneous present and multifocal subcutaneous port could be due to tubercular infection. And this polymerization reaction for evaluation of infection of multifocal subcutaneous choroiditis, then they found Kumbhava Bhushu group found that 9 of the eyes are positive for 1 or TB is the most common organism. So it's to believe that the TB is more and there is a continued progression of tubercular subcutaneous choroiditis found in 14% of the patients after antiviral therapy. So such patients require increased immunosuppression and this was given in the form of antiviral therapy. Progressive ocular inflammation following antiviral therapy for present ocular tuberculosis was also supported by Bhushu article. we published an article and we found that immunosuppression is useful in succinous chorioretic to systemic sclerosis. One can give you an interesting message. Challenges initial confusion, active tension, nervous pain, acquired responder, assiduous monitoring of the intraocular pressure, both there and outside. Uncontrolled diabetes, initial insulin, transplanting, progression of the disease, despite HTS, and this patient's progression was